Hi students, a very pleasant and warm greetings to you all. Hope you are doing good. This is our computer application class. We have completed till computer networks, right? You have completed our 10th chapter, computer networks. And today we are going to see about network examples and protocols, right? We all would have heard IP, TCP and all. Now we are going to learn about this internet protocol. What is internet? What is intranet? Extranet? These are all the things we are going to learn in this network examples and protocols chapter, right? First one is internet protocol. What is internet protocol? This internet protocol only we'll say it is IP, right? This is the principle of communication protocol among the internet protocols for layering on datagram across the boundaries of other networks. Network means it is a collection of computer, right? Many computers can be connected through this network, right? This internet protocol, this IP, will discharge the packets from the source and it will deliver it to the destination host, right? Their host will be there. From this source host, the packets will be taken and it will be delivered to the destination host through this IP address, right? A packet header, all the packet header will have a IP address. Using this IP address, this source host will send the packets to the destination host, right? This process only we'll say it is, this internet protocol will do this process, right? Network protocol means this is a rule, or this is a procedure, or this is a process, and it has some policies also. This allows the communication between more than one devices, right? If more than one device is connected through this network protocol will have some rules or some procedure or will have some policies which allows this communication in between this devices which is connected to a network, right? This network protocol will have to do end-to-end process of secure on time. That means from one source to one destination, from that end till this end, this network protocol will do the process of secure. The content or the data must be secured and it must reach on time also, right? So this network protocol have to do end to end process of secure and on time, right? This will help us to manage the data, or this helps us to do the communication between the devices connected in the network, right? Here, this communication is done between the devices like a router, servers, computer, laptop or mobile, whatever devices are connected in that network, in this all devices, this communication will be done, right? Here, in this network protocol, must be installed, and this routers also must be installed both in the sender side and also in the receiver side. That we saw in the first itself, in the source side and also in the destination. That only here we are saying it is sender and receiver. Source is the sender and the destination is the receiver, right? In both the sides, this network protocol and this routers will be installed, right? And to ensure the data or network communication only, this network protocol might be installed, right? Next one is the broad types of networking protocols includes. First point is the basic data communication protocol consists of HTTP and TCP bar IP. About this HTTP and this TCP bar IP and all, we learn in this chapter, right? The next point is this will implement the security over this network communication, and this also includes HTTP, SFTP and SSL, right? The next point is this will provide network governance and maintenance, which includes ICMP and SNMP, right? Here, broad types of network protocols includes, here they have given 3 points. Basic Data Communication Protocol, which consists of HTTP and TCP bar IP. The next one is implement security over the network communication. And the next one is will provide network governance and maintenance, right? Now we are going to see about internet, intranet and extranet, right? Internet, what do you know about internet? Net, right? We all need internet connection. To even to watch this video, you need internet connection, right? The net. This is a worldwide system of computer networks, right? So this network means if you are having net only, you can access Google or you can access this YouTube. Any type of networking activities can be done only when you are connected with this network, right? So this internet, the net is a worldwide system of computer networks and network of networks where this user will be at any one computer or any one mobile, and if you are having the information or if you are having the permission to use the data only, you can use it, right? When you are having the access only, you can use it. This was noticed by the Advanced Research Projects Agency, ARPA, of the US government in the year 1969, and this was first recognized as the ARPANET. Okay, this was noticed that only in your book they have given us perceived, that is it was noticed or it was recognized by this ARPA by the US government in the year 1969, and they told it as ARPANET. Okay, this is introduced by ARPA and they named it as ARPANET. Okay, the main aim was to generate a network that would permit users of a research computer from one university to talk to the research computers in another place in another university, right? This ARPA is an Advanced Research Projects Agency, right? So this agency need to communicate from one computer to another computer which is present on two different universities. So for this process only they have recognized this as ARPANET, and they generated this network to allow the researchers to communicate each other who are in two different places or in two different universities, right? This internet is a network of global connections. This will consist of private connections, public, or maybe for business, for government networks, maybe for academic users. For everything, this networking has the global connections for this all users. All right, this is linked by guided or maybe wireless or maybe it has fiber optic technologies also, right? The main aim is to generate the network which helps us to communicate, right? The jargons internet and world wide web are frequently used, and these are interchangeably, but they are not precisely the same. These are not the same. The jargons internet and this world wide web is not same, but this internet denotes to the global communication system. Global means we all know this does not says that it has a specific place limit or the time limit. Wherever we are, whichever country you are, you can just connect through this network. So here they are saying it is this denotes the global communication system, including the infrastructure and hardware, whereas the web is one of the services which is interconnected over the internet, right? In this diagram also you can see only we need net. If we have net, wherever we are we can get connected, right? That is internet. Next one is intranet. Intranet means this is a private network within an enterprise to share the company data and computing resources between the persons or between the workers or the employees who are inside that company, right? One main server or one main block will be there. From there, it will be connected to the people or the employees who are working inside that particular company, right? This consists of many interlinked local area networks, which includes the connections through one or more networks, or it will have different protocols together, which is known as protocol converter, right? When you see this diagram, you can understand. See, it has one or more gateway, and this main thing is connected to some number of computers. So this is used inside one organization or inside one company or inside one block, right? Next one is extranet. Extranet means this is also a private network that uses internet technology and the private telecommunication system. This is used to share the information or the data in one business with much security, right? It may have suppliers, it may have partners and customers, and it may also have some other businesses also. Between this, only this, inside this network, it is a private network, right? So inside this network, the data or the information must be carried out with more secure. So for this only, this extranet is there, right? Understood what is extranet? It is a private network which use this internet technology and this public telecommunication system to securely share the business information with the customers, partners, vendors, suppliers, and within the business limits, right? That is extranet, right? The comparison of internet, intranet, extranet are given. Definition for internet is a global network, public TCP bar IP. TCP means transmission control protocol, and IP is internet protocol, right? A global network, public TCP bar IP network, used by over a billion people all over the world, right? For an example, you can say you are just mailing your friend, or you are just sending one message to one person. That one you can say it as an example for internet, right? For intranet, a TCP bar IP network with access restricted to members of an organization, right? This IP network will access only to the people who are inside a company or into a restricted amount of place or into a restricted building, right? And for this intranet, you can say the example is accessing your record in the employee personnel file, right? You are in a school, you are having your details inside one computer, means only the people who are inside the school can access it, right? That one is the example for this intranet, right? Extranet means a TCP bar IP network with restricted access to members. That means for this you can say an example is checking the availability of inventory from an outside supplier, right? That means when you are going to buy something, the shopkeeper or the a person who is selling it will just give you the information or will give you the ID or the login details to see what are the products they are having, right? That means you can access it when you are going to buy, or when you are being a buyer, you can access the details of the things in that shop, right? So this one is extranet. Understood the difference between internet, intranet, and extranet? And now we are going to see about this network application, right? Where all we will use this internet, where this intranet is used, and where this extranet is used, that only now we are going to see, okay? First, let's see what are the application of this internet, okay? To download the programs and files for all the social media, Facebook, WhatsApp, Twitter, Instagram, everything, YouTube, Google. For this we need internet, right? So for this social media and for mailing, email, for transaction of money and all, we are using internet only. So we can say it as e-banking, audio conferencing, video conferencing, e-commerce, file sharing, e-governance, information browsing, or to search some web address, to access or to search something through a search engine, or to chat or to send your images or your data to another person. For this and all, you need this internet, right? So these are the uses of internet. And then application of intranet means sharing of company policies or the procedures or the rules which is in a specific company. We'll say it as this uses what? Intranet, okay? And access employee database, distribution of circulars or the office orders or the orders which must be seen only with the person who are working there. For these places and all, this intranet is working, right? Access product and customer data to see what are the products there and to see what who are working there. For this process and all, this intranet is used, right? Sharing of information of common interest, launching of personal or departmental home pages, submission of the reports, corporate telephone directories, these and all are application of intranet, right? Next, we are going to see about extranet. The application of extranet are communication between the customers, right? This customer communication, when a customer is coming and a customer needs something, the details from the company will be sent to the customer or will be shown to the customer, right? So this customer communication is the main use of extranet, right? Online education or a training. When you are a student, you can access the particular school. If you are a student of Bethlehem, if this Bethlehem is having a website, if only if you are a student, you can just enter into their website and you can just and give your ID or your name and your number and you can just view the details about that school, right? So online education, training, account status inquiry, inventory inquiry, online discussion, supply chain management, order status inquiry, warranty registration, claims, distributor promotions, these all are the application of extranet, right? The next one is mobile networks. Mobile network or the cellular network means this is made of a large number of signal area, right? This we'll say it as cell. Okay, this cells will join to form a large coverage area. Right? When you see this diagram, you can see each one is a cell, and when you say a collection of cell, we'll say it as a coverage area, right? User can cross into different cells without losing their connection also. With each cell, there will be a base station. Okay, within each cell, there will be a base station, and this will send and receive the mobile signals. Okay, mobile device will be connected to the nearest base station. When you are around Karangal, means if Karangal is having a base station, means if you are around Karangal, you will have the your mobile network will be connected with that particular base station, right? The base station are connected to a digital exchange where the communication is sent to other telephone or another networks, right? Cells will often be smaller in size in large towns as the number of users are in the area. Because why means when in if it is a city, there will be more people who use networks, right? So if a base station or if a cell is there in a city, it will have a small area only. If it is in a village, means in village side and all, if you see, more people won't be using internet, mobile and all, right? Only people will use in a home, one or two phones will be there, and it will be rare only. Networks and all they won't be using, right? So in that places and all, the cells will be large. Okay, the communication over mobile network is made up of voice, it may be a data, it may be an image or a text message, right? This mobile network assigns to the technology support voice or data, network connectivity through radio transmission solution also, right? The communication is done between the people or from one end to another end, because here if you see, one data or one image or one text must be shared from one person to another person. For this, we need a network. To make it easy, we are using mobile networks, right? The common application of these mobile networks is mobile phone, tabs and all, right? Previously, if you see, we had only wired communication, right? In this wireless communication are largely used circuit switching to carry only the voice over a network, right? Previously and all, we had only button phones and we can only talk with it. We can't use the internet and we can't share the text and all, right? Now, if you see, we can connect the device through this network, and not only voice, we can send the data or we can send video or audio, anything through this networks, right? The generation of this mobile network means first generation is 1981, that is NMT launch, right? We'll see this in detail. Now I'm just saying the headings, right? Second generation is 2G. First generation we'll say it is 1G. Second generation is 2G in the year 1991. That is Global System for Mobile Communication, GSM, right? First generation is 1G. That is Nordic Mobile Telephone, right? That is NMT. And second to third generation is GPRS, right? That is second to third generation bridge 2.0 in the year 2000, right? In the year 2000, that is GPRS. GPRS, we all know, General Packet Radio Service, right? And the next one, third generation 3G, that is in the year 2003. That is UK 3G launch, right? This 3G, we all know, third generation 3G came in the year 2003, right? And next one is 4G, that is fourth generation in the year 2007, and now it's almost done, right? 5G, fifth generation, after 2019 only this fifth generation came, right? We'll see about this generation and about this TCP, IP, RFID tags, and about the Wi-Fi and advantages, and the definition of this HTTP, TCP, IP, and the different layers of this TCP, IP and all in the next session, right? And today we have seen about the network examples and protocols, right? Networks, you know what is networks now, right? What is internet protocol? And you had a clear idea about what is internet, intranet and extranet, right? And about the generation, we'll see in the next session. You have just started to learn about this mobile communication network, right? Mobile networks we have learned, and the generation of this mobile networks, we'll see the brief explanation in the next session, okay? Thank you for your valuable time. Stay home, stay safe, take care, bye.